Namaste, Javadekar Sahib.
Namaste.
I am so happy to see Honorable Minister visiting and inaugurating the AVU facility, sir. IIT Bombay and IIT Kharagpur have been major users of this facility. You may be aware that we run 10,000 teachers at a time training program. We have trained more than 1,33,000 teachers, thankfully under the aegis of MHRD's national mission. And we have more than 357 remote centers, out of which more than 200 participate in a single workshop that we conduct. Sir, this is the largest training of its kind anywhere in the world. And I'm very happy to thank MHRD and the national mission for this. My colleague, Professor Kannan is here, who is the coordinator of all national mission projects at IIT Bombay. I'll request him to mention a few details about those projects, sir.
Namaskar. We have projects like Spoken Tutorial, E-Yantra, and E-Kalpa, in addition to the 10,000 teacher training program, funded by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD. There are a total of about 300 full-time staff members working with about 15 faculty members. We have a large number of masters and PhD students also. We have used AVU to promote these projects as well. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, very nice.
Over to you.
I'm very happy today to launch this AVU. You have already evolved a technology which is of great importance to everybody. Can you listen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, this is a real development because multiplication is power, and live classes by IIT to 1,000 of students in IIT Madras. And I find this is very important because wherever I go, I am asking a question to all the students who wants to be the faculty next. At some places, the response is good, as I got yesterday in ICER Mohali. But in IIM Shillong, there was nobody ready to become faculty. So that there will be shortage of faculty, good faculties in days to come, maybe. But we need to, this technology to take good teaching. Good teachers can reach out to thousands of schools and lakhs of children simultaneously. So Swayam is one part of the story, but AVU is also very important. I was chairman for working group on for masses of Government of India in year 2000. And that time I remember very, we decided to have every weekly meeting on Tuesday. So I used to use 32 screens of NIC, and all participants used to come to the NIC centers at their convenient places. And things happened very smoothly. In 3 months, we could produce a report. And that's how things can be worked out. It increases efficiency. It increases our reach. It increases the richness of the content and more interaction. I declare that the AVU 5.0 is released and is open now for use all over the world.
Next slide. Next. Sir, we are very happy to say that AVU is already being used in 10,000 institutions back all over India. And this 10,000 institutions are listed on our website. They are mostly colleges. Next. I would like to say that with a lot of support and some push by, you know, specifically Professor Fatak and Kannan, now we have made AVU completely open source. And it is available to the entire world, this project, sir, to use it and modify it. Anybody can customize it and change it according to their liking. Anybody can set it up on their own premises. Anybody can use it. Anybody can integrate it. It works on internet, satellite, and LAN. And I would really like to thank Professor Kannan and Professor Fatak, who have been instrumental in guiding us. Amrita and IIT Bombay have had a long relation, and now IIT Kharagpur also together. You know, Amrita has developed this from the start, but we have had great guidance and support from IIT Bombay. Next.
Now I can easily, you know, start using it and, you know, take all the benefit out of other IIMs or better people.
Next. So this can also, you can record your own lectures in this version of AVIEW, which means that you can create your own content basically with video, with your own audio video. Next. You can also monitor people. That means with AVIEW across India, you can monitor what is going on. We are also customizing it so that you can monitor it for invigilation and exams. So you can actually see what is going on, and you can zoom into people as you need to. Next. There will be two types of AVIEW mobile apps. One is the regular app, which will give you all the functions of AVIEW. But because it is a video conferencing project, it does not work on the very lowest end mobile apps. So AVIEW Lite will work on any phone, the lightest and the cheapest smartphone. And it will be like the WhatsApp of education, and it will allow you to do quizzes, polls, and questions live. Next. There are many more features that I can go on, but I'd like to pause here and show you that, you know, we are working on many other features also. We will have now Kiran give like a 1 minute demonstration of some of the features of AVIEW, and then we will interact with a few other institutions.
Hi, this is a demo class on sustainable energy, where energy can be produced from wind. So this is a very typical three blade design windmill. Let us see how a windmill actually works. So I'm loading something known as a 3D viewer, where I'm going to zoom in on a windmill. So here I can see that here are the blades of the windmill. You can see the label also. Here are some gears. There is a belt, a coil, and an electrical meter body. So I can turn this around and show this, how this thing looks from various angles. And a very interesting feature is that I can play an animation, and it actually shows how the windmill and the gear system and the coils move. And finally, we can see how the power is coming here in this meter body. Now let us take a look at a whiteboard wherein we have actually showed you the power and the wind speed relationship. So the windmill actually starts only at something known as a cut-in speed. And here at 3 meters per second is known as a cut-in speed, where power generation starts. Then with the wind speed, the power increases and reaches a rated output power. And this point is known as a cut-out speed, this particular point wherein the wind energy stops and the windmill stops. So thank you very much. This was a small demo class where we have seen three features: document, a whiteboard, and a 3D viewer. Thank you very much.
And we can also do quiz and polling. So you can have thousands of people logged in. As Professor Fatak said, he has conducted 10,000 teacher classes. We will now interact with a few other institutes. So we have IIT Madras, who runs the quality enhancement program under Professor Junjunwala. Akhila, please go ahead.
Go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. This is Akhila speaking on behalf of Professor Ashok Junjunwala. Professor, our project is called as QEEE, which is Quality Enhancement in Engineering Education. We are running this project from 2014 to about reaching to about 120 colleges, engineering colleges, tier 1 and tier 2 colleges. And we have right now in this current phase, we have around 68,000 students benefiting out of this program. And we have around short modules. We concentrate on short modules teaching to the students, which are core engineering topics, targeting mostly the first, second, and the third year students. This is about a program, sir.
IIT Kharagpur?
Yeah.
Please go ahead.
Namaskar, sir. This is Professor Raja Datta from IIT Kharagpur. Yeah. So we are running a train 10,000 teachers program from January to 2013. And till now, we have conducted 6 complete workshops, and we have trained more than 45,000 teachers online. And the best part of it is that we are maintaining a gender ratio of 36% of women teachers being trained out of that 45,000 teachers. And the reason being that once we are teaching online, and the women teachers can take this course from nearer to their home, and they don't need to come to the places like IITs and all. So this is one of the best part of it. The second is that we are getting a very good age group of the participants, like 25 to 30. We are getting 43% of the participants are in the age group of 25 to 30. Around 27% is 30 to 35. And then less than also 25 years of age also around 12%, those who are fresh BTEC. And they have just joined as a faculty, but then they want to become, they want to complete their masters and PhDs. So that is the thing. And overall rating, even if you are taking it online, we have got a very good overall rating of the courses, like around 45% is excellent, and 42% we have got very good. So the quality of the courses are not compromised if you are doing this type of online courses, and obviously AVU has helped us a lot in this. Thank you. That's from IIT Kharagpur, sir.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Senthil from ISRO, IIRS Dehradun, please go ahead.
Yeah, very good afternoon, sir. Honorable Minister for MHRD. IIRS, Indian Institute of Remote Sensing, is a unit of ISRO dedicated for imparting training and education in the field of remote sensing, GIS and GNSS. It's partly, as you know, last year we had a Prime Minister addressing to the ISRO initiated meeting, national meet on use of geospatial technology for governance. So we have been doing this for quite a long time. In fact, our outreach program, we have been training the students for building up the capacity building for the country. And also we have started this program with the help of AVU software as early as August 2011. In fact, first of all, I sincerely thank MHRD and the developers of AVU platform for providing such a very workable and a very interactive platform for distance learning. And we have conducted quite a number of courses. Of course, we are now doing 12 courses with the help of Amrita University. And already 32,000 participants have been benefited, and we are already connected to 462 institutions, in which we have 301 the academic institutions as well as the government organizations, more than about 151. Now with the geospatial technology importance raised by our Honorable Prime Minister in the national meet, there are lot many state government departments are now joining in our courses. So knowing their importance and requirements, now we have started short-term courses which are really well appreciated and being attended by many state government officials also. So we are very, very much benefited from this, and we will continue our support for the government, and particularly in the use of geospatial technology for governance, and also improving the geospatial technology for the governance as well as for building the capacity building for the country. And of course, we we are very happy to note from the release that now we are going to have the satellite networking also in AVU 5.0. This is going to be a very important component, and I'm sure ISRO jointly with AVU will contribute many more contexts. In fact, we have been just completed the state meet with Himachal Pradesh and many other states where the connectivity is a problem by terrestrial. And I'm sure with the help of AVU and the satellite networking from ISRO, we should be able to reach the unreachable students as well as officials. Thank you very much for this opportunity, and look forward to hear from you something.
Swami Ravanand.
Yeah, I would just request, there are a few more institute. I would just request everyone to please, since the minister has to leave in a few minutes, Please be brief to, please keep it to around 30 seconds. Good. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I am very happy to interact with Honorable Minister. And I am happy to say that AVU has been very useful for this university. We have been broadcasting many national programs and to the colleges and institutes. And many students have interacted through that. Last 2 years, I am conducting one program where I talk to the students and teachers directly through AVU at the beginning of the year. And I listen to the students about their problems, suggestions, and they, that is how we carry out that for throughout the year. And this being a very means area where there is a rural and tribal background also, I'm very happy that even the remotest villages, they are actually interacting and they are participating in this program. And in future, we plan to actually conduct certain, say, courses with the help of AVU, like, say, foundation course in competitive examination and all. Javadekar Sahib, khup ananda vatla aplyashi bolun. आणि ही एक चांगली फॅसिलिटी आहे आणि त्याचा उपयोग सगळ्यांना निश्चितपणे होईल तर थँक्यू
निश्चितपणे होईल आणि मराठवाड्यामध्ये तुम्ही चांगले काम करताय आणि त्याचा केवढा विद्यार्थ्यांना फायदा होतोय अभिनंदन
थँक्यू सर
अमल ज्योती प्लीज गो अहेड प्लीज कीप इट शॉर्ट
यस डॉक्टर जोस प्रिंसिपल ऑफ अमल ज्योती कॉलेज ऑफ इंजिनियरिंग Kottayam is speaking. Ah, hello, go ahead, sir.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Just select somebody else quickly. We'll come back to him. Just call him on the phone. And
yes, Father Jose, principal of Amal Jyothi College of Engineering, Kottayam, Kerala is speaking. We were using this AVU right from the beginning as IIT Bombay was organizing the classes, the remote classes, we were also participating right from the beginning. And in the first evaluation, among the... Yes. Among the remote centers, Amal Jyothi was rated as the five-star remote center. And we were making use of it thereafter, after the model of the IITs. We also started doing things on our own. We connected some around 12, 13 centers in Kerala initially, and we're having a one-day seminar. Thereafter, we took it nationally. We could connect some around 45 centers, and when we could give a two-day seminar, which was on research methodology, and the number of participants were more than 3,000. And last year, we could conduct a national conference. The presentations took place from different states, from different centers, and participants also were from different places. And it was a fabulous thing. We could do it in a very good way. And we are making use of the potentials of this AVU. And we are extremely happy to see that AVU version 5 is getting released now, Honorable Minister. We are extremely happy to join. We will support in every way, and we will make use of all the opportunities that are given us. And also there is a request to the minister, if possible, AJC also must be connected on to NK, National Knowledge Network, as well. I think it is yes. Already been connected to colleges as ours. This is a self-financing college, but we are doing very good work connecting most of the colleges in Kerala and even outside. And also, if possible, TechKeep also, can it be extended to colleges like ours? This one request to Honorable Minister.
Thank you. As far as
thank you very much.
I am concerned, my only mission is to improve quality of higher education and even in primary education. So using technology all over, and there is no self-financing or private or public. Networking is for all. And so I'm holding a separate meeting also for that. And so we'll take this technology and benefit arising out of it to all the institutes who want it, because I think students have right to a better education, to a quality education.
Dr. Mohan Sen, please go ahead.
Sir. Very good afternoon, sir. to you and Honorable Minister. On behalf of the RGPV, I welcome both of you for developing this wonderful system which is being used all over MP for conducting the practical online examinations. The RGPV, this is the Rajiv Gandhi Project Vishwavidyalaya. It has conducted the biopsy part of the practical examination successfully of about 80,000 students, 40,000 in each semester by using the AVU. And I am on behalf of the RGPV thankful to Professor Bijlani sir for developing the high quality application for conducting this biopsy part of the examination. As Honorable Minister sir, as you are aware of that there are many private colleges across the states and they do not have the faculty. So to conduct the practical examination in a very short period of time is very difficult. And so we are very thankful for Professor Kamal Bijlani to develop that application based on AVU to conduct the biopsy part of the practical examination, and it has been done very successfully. And that examination was conducted online in the real-time basis by actually deploying the connectivity through servers at Hyderabad. So we are very thankful to you. And my request is, sir, to have the interface of this AVU in Hindi. So the maximum actually people across the, say, student, they are coming from the rural background. So they can able to understand and can make the use of this very, very successful. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, you Professor Sen, you raised two important issues. A,
yes,
that students will get good education and you can conduct practical examinations with this help of AVU. But shortage of faculty will not be condoned. It should be used as a faculty development program. Because I learn every day from somebody who speaks more good than me, who does something very nicely than me. So I learn from everybody. So everybody has to learn. And this is a great learning tool. So that is one aspect.
Yes.
So it is not compromising quality or deficiencies. It is actually more of an encouragement to improve the quality.
Yes, sir. Even we are able to use the AVU even in the tribal parts of the state like Betul and Balaghat. So that was basically the quality of the program and the kind of the platform that it has given us the, it has facilitated us to conduct this examination across all parts of the Madhya Pradesh, sir. Thank you very much.
Very good.
Next.
Hello, Nitar Bhopal. Can you please talk?
Good afternoon, sir.
Go ahead.
Sir, namaskar, Bhopal, Nitar Bhopal. We have conducted using AV technology successfully some of the very good programs of teacher training across country. Our initial phases for 2 years, we use this platform for connecting to 40 different polytechnics within, not only within the western region, that is Gujarat, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, but also across other states, namely Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. And looking at the ability to reach out to such a wider population of teachers, we are quite encouraged that the features of Release 5 would even enable us in much more efficient and better ways to harness this technology for reaching out to the teachers in polytechnic and engineering colleges, sir. In fact, sir, there is dire need to use this technology in wake of the newer outcome-based paradigm which our country has introduced in engineering education system. And looking at the paucity of teachers who are knowledgeable about such newer paradigms, I think best use of such technologies can be that we use AVU not only for conventional teacher training programs, but also for introducing newer reforms and the innovations in the education system. Thank you, sir. We look forward to using this in much more efficient and better ways.
I gave two chances for two MP institutes because I am MP from MP. But Agartala.
Yes, hello.
Namaskar sir, Javadekar sir, Honorable Minister for HRD. I'm Dr. Gopal Mugaraya, representing the remote place of India. I'm a director of NIT Agartala and NIT Mizoram. Even though I'm South Indian, I took a challenge of working in Northeast. Incidentally, we are blessed with our BOG chairman is Dr. Patak, and we have been using this AV very effectively. And we had a great challenge of the connectivity in Northeast. As you know, to physically come to Agartala is so difficult. Personally, we took the challenge. And through this AV, we are training our student and faculty. As rightly HRD Minister said, this AV should be used as icing on the cake, should not be used as a cake. Our teaching learning process should continue, and AV effort can be for icing of the cake. And I should congratulate Dr. Patak and Amrita for this wonderful initiative. And we are using it, and we are going to use it effectively for the overall development of Northeast sections. Sir, we expect you to come and bless us in our place in Agartala and encourage our faculty members.
Absolutely, I'll come. Next. अब लोग बैठे हैं तो उनसे बात करेंगे
JNTU, are you ready? JNTU Kakinada?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Kakinada, go ahead.
Maniya Mantri Mahode, Javadekar ji, good morning, sir. And remaining dignitaries. It's a pleasure to use AV, sir. We have effectively utilized. Ours is a technological university with 262 affiliated colleges. So we started giving our own courses taught by the experts from IIT Chennai, Tata Consultancy Services, and professors from Berkeley Extension Center in the crucial areas of data structures, database, big data analytics. These subjects we were handling, sir. And simultaneously, we were deploying one faculty member from each private college so that they will be trained under the expertise of those people. And they will be helping in solving some assignments also, sir. So we are comfortable that the quality of education will enhance through this. And we are very much thankful to the AVU for providing this opportunity, sir. And we have an MOU, and around in our curriculum, around 12,000 students are being benefited, sir. We started 1 year back, started with around 500 students. Now 12,000 students are being benefited
very
with
nice.
This, sir. And we are trying, sir.
No, Andhra Pradesh has already taken lead in Gyan also. Foreign faculties coming in and completing the courses, giving good lectures to our students. And then simultaneously, you have also, some universities have started online courses of their own. I welcome all such ventures, because everything adds something new to the efforts.
No. Nitter Chennai, please go ahead. GTU.
Nitter Chennai. Hello, Honorable Minister. Myself, actually, Director Nitter Chennai. So, actually, every year, actually, we turn our AVU program. Every year, we train around 2,500 teachers of polytechnics and engineering colleges for South Indian states. Of 5 states and 1 union territory. So this program actually very effectively applies for transferring the knowledge at the engineering college level as well as polytechnic. Actually, we want that, we're happy that this also can be enhanced to a higher version that will be helpful for our 5 South Indian states and 1 union territory, that is Pondicherry. And we are looking after this program is more effective for transferring knowledge at the engineering college and other polytechnics. Thank you very much.
Thank you. GTU, please.
Yes, this is Vithal Kamat, director of the Sankul of GTU. Basically, the Sankul concept was introduced by Dr. Akshay Agarwal to basically link up the industries with the various academic institutions. So my role has been to basically offer state-of-the-art technology solutions to the students of GTU. Essentially, we have noticed that under GTU, we have a large number of private institutes which do not have access to quality teachers. So our role was basically to fill in that gap, and we took up a course, say one course in electronics, where we noticed that students were, you know, tempted to opt for projects from the open market rather than build the projects in the various institutes themselves by with their own hands. So we took up a very interesting, you know, project to bring in state-of-the-art technologies to the students, wherein they would build their projects with their own hands. And we used the AVU as an effective platform for conducting this kind of experiment. So it was a very successful experiment. A large number of institutes, we have over 100 engineering colleges under GTU. So all of them participated in this wonderful venture. Thank you.
Yeah, Nitar, Kolkata.
Hold, yeah. Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, sirs. We have been using AVU for a long time, and we will look forward to use it more to cover remote area, teachers as well as students. We thank you for giving the opportunity. We look forward to use it more so that we can reach a wider number of faculty from polytechnics as well as engineering colleges. Thank you.
I think we covered most of this.
Yeah,
so.
But I am very happy, and let me again reiterate, government is committed to increase the use of technology, more innovation in communication, because this is ultimately, is I think the student's right to get best education. If he is not served by the professors or teachers there because of paucity of because of many things, and this will also encourage teachers to become good teachers, to become best teachers, because that motivation should not end because somebody's best teacher is available online and therefore I should be lazy. That won't work. I think it will work as a motivation to all the teachers to become better and best, and therefore this AVU is really, I saw it after doctor requested me, but this is, I'm so happy today because this is the technology which we are using very effectively, and I saw the effect right now. So I think thousands of students and thousands of faculties will benefit from this, and this is where we want to take. And particularly I like the invigilation work. It was too difficult to invigilate without technology earlier. I was Senate member at my age of 25, and I appeared in two notorious center as a student with taking ticket from Vice Chancellor. And then I went as a student inside. I started writing paper, and then I saw who is doing all copies, and then I grabbed them all and threw them out. So that was a very surprising action for all the classes. But that's how things happen. Now technology has brought us, we can see from, but it will be a chor sipai, police chor sipai khel chalega, because they come up with something new, we have to come up with news, something new. But that's how we can keep. So ye nahi hoga ki topper hi farar hai, ye nobat kabhi nahi aayegi. I think that's what we should all aim at. So there are n number of uses of technology and this facility of communication. I'm so happy to release this AVU 5.0. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of Amrita and IIT Bombay, our close partner, and HRD Ministry, we would like to conclude this program for today. Thank you all for attending. Thank you all for using AVU and supporting it. And we look forward to continue working with all of you in the near future. Thank you very much. Good afternoon.